Pangan Nuru. Hello. Whoa, my eye just felt like it was on fire suddenly. It's good now though, it's just like suddenly a biting pain for no reason. Anyways.
Hello, how you doing?
Welcome back to the art stream. Let me, you know, these are the renders I did, by the way. The last render that I did right before I left, and I'm not gonna lie, I do be looking kind of sexy. Do be looking a little wonky. The lights are not. There's something not going on right with any of the lights, but we'll figure it out. But yeah. Kind of don't know if I like it more or less without the volumetric light. It's not gonna lie. But anyways, yeah, we are gonna finish. Not finish this, but... Well, possibly finish, but I'm working on a Monstera plant. Facing my fears. Because you guys know I've been trying to do this Monstera plant for, like, a year. And I've always had a really hard time with the geometry. So we're gonna take another crack at it.
Also, hello, Kevin. How you doing today? What's up? What's good into hood? What's good into Kevin hood?
Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna face my fears and do the Monstera plant. Or keep trying to, because I love these plants so much. They're so beautiful. Yeah, let's just get to it. Oh, one second, let me adjust my... I have my laptop open on the side. I may or may not be trying to make a build for something, and it's just taking a while, so... Why is the beat not working? What? Am I going crazy? I'm just gonna hit undo a shit ton of times. I think I toggled something by accident. Hold up. Okay, the select... Okay, the double click to, like, select the whole thing is working again. I think I toggled something by accident. Hope it builds. I'm actually... Hello, Rogue. I'm building something we both hate. Or I don't know if you hate it, but you know. I don't hate it, but you know what I'm building. I have to run a really stupid terminal command, specifically on the Mac build, because otherwise it won't fucking open. Thank you. It's a toggle. It's gotta be some kind of toggle that I keep pressing by accident. I think it's G. Okay. Yeah, sorry. I was aggressively hitting buttons like near the B key on my keyboard just now just to see which key was causing that behavior. I don't think this is gonna look good, but fuck it, we'll figure it out. I was gonna ask how's working on a Mac for that stuff. Not the greatest, I'll be completely honest. I've had a Mac since 2016. The Mac I have right now is the 2020. It has M1 chip, and I gotta say, I'm not very impressed with this Mac, to be completely honest. I really liked the 2016 Mac. I don't like this Mac that much. But maybe could use for engineering too. I will say, sorry, that was really loud, I saw the audio hit. I'm gonna move the mic a little further from my mouth. I will say the Mac is surprisingly powerful. A lot of my problems with the Mac actually don't have to do with, like, its ability to use Unity. I haven't really tried it for any kind of software development other than Unity, so I can't, like, say anything about that. But, my problems with this current Mac don't really have to do that much with Unity. Or some of them, but it's a very small amount. Hopefully someone didn't mess it up even more somehow. Something I broke. No, dude, it's a Git thing, I swear. Like, yesterday during the build review, it was pain, man. Because I was like, no, I literally was saying to them, like, we finally fixed the defend command not working. And then, lo and behold, Trooper fucking defended, and the golem didn't bop him for half, like, a quarter of his HP. And I was like, this is so embarrassing. Like, David, I'm sorry, I'm making David look so bad here. Okay, that looks terrible. That looks beyond awful. Holy shit. Oh, I know what I did wrong. I'm not supposed to drag this vertice. Here we go. Like that. There we go. It's still gonna look a little weird, but it'll look better. Wait, why did it curve? Oh, I know why. Okay. That was the first attempt. We're gonna try it again out here. 2016 is per power, what's the difference? It's not necessarily power. I really do just find that this Mac can't. How do I say? Like, I'm running into issues that I never have run into on Mac. So, for example, like, sometimes if I click, like, right-click on it, and, right, so for example, if I right-click a folder and I click compress, nowadays I get some error, couldn't communicate with the helper application. I've never run into that on the former Mac, and I guess that's more of a, that might be more of an OS thing than an actual computer thing. But like, honestly, a lot of my issues with the Mac, I don't know if it's an OS thing or a model thing, but I found that this computer does crash a lot more, genuinely. And, like, it takes so long for it to, like, I do not know why. It took, like, 5 minutes. I know that's such a short amount of time, but it took, like, 5 minutes to delete a file. And I'm like, what's wrong with this computer? And, like, I'm, like, kind to the computer. I don't even use this laptop all that much because I do most of my heavy, robust stuff on my PC. I saw you guys panicking in the Discord. It was a time. It was certainly a time. I'm not gonna lie, at first I thought it was a me thing because a couple weeks ago I was working with someone else and I found that I just had some weird corrupt copy of the project actually. Because they were like, it's working on my end, and I'm like, it's not working for me. And then so I recloned and it worked again. Which was just like a fucking classic Unity, thanks man. Or classic Git, sorry, it's not a Unity issue. But it was just felt like so ridiculous. Maybe OS are bloatware, but I assume they don't get bloatware like Windows laptops. No, definitely not. I will say, a huge benefit to Mac, right, is like, you'll never get a computer virus. Right? It's so fucking hard to get a virus on Mac. Like, that is a very big plus. Git plus Unity is ass, though. Yeah, I know, because Git is not made for shit like Unity. It's just unlucky that we don't have Perforce. Let's pray. Okay, that's looking pretty not awful. I am gonna connect to this though. I thought it might give a slightly better look if it wasn't connected, but I think it needs to be connected. Let's like straighten it out a little. Actually, no, it's okay at an angle. As long as it's a straight line, it's okay that it's angled. Kev, you in the project Discord? Yeah, Kev. Yeah, worked on it for a few months. Yeah, Rogue really coming back in at like a really good time to help out, honestly. I feel like I'm stealing valor. What do you mean? How do you mean by that? Leaf is looking fire. Thank you! I've tried this stupid Monstera fucking plant many times for the last couple of years, or last like year at least. People who have like watched the art streams regularly like know how much this has like how difficult this has been for me to get do, and I don't know why, but. I did actually find like a little bit of a tutorial that like gives kind of tips on how to do this plant, and it does it in Blender. I'm doing it in Maya, right, following the same modeling principles, because modeling principles don't change between software, right? But I will say this one, I can see how it would benefit from having some of the tool, like the more unique tools that Blender has. So yeah, unironically, I might try this in Blender in a second, or export this shape into Blender. Okay, it is getting a little better as we go. Here for sure, so worth the effort. Hell yeah, I do love these plants. I think they're beautiful. So wait, let me close Discord because I'm hearing pings. Is it important? Okay, it's not important. Me casually looking at the project Discord. I feel like I'm stealing valor by like coming in at the end and saying, no, dude, you were here at the very start. Like, I don't remember. I don't know if you happen to remember this, because I... Please don't get creeped out by, like, my memory and, like, what I'm about to share. Oh, stupid. This bug is pissing me off. Like, a real bug, not a... Oh, I do have a funny story. So, a couple weeks ago during Game Jam, right, at the very end, like, we had just submitted our build, and one of my teammates was like, oh my god, that's a huge bug. And, like, me and my other two teammates, like, I didn't do programming on the project. But, like, me and the other two teammates were the programmers. We all just, like, froze. Felt our bodies just, like, cease to exist. And then we were like, bug? And she was like, yeah, no, this mosquito's huge. And we're like, oh, and we're like, don't do that in a room of programmers. So yeah, that was kind of funny. But anyways, so yeah, my other story is like, so I'm, please forgive me, and you'll be like, why do you remember this? And I'll be like, I don't know, but like, in the very beginning when we were first trying out the combat system, right? And then we were talking about like, how we wanted to implement it, right? And we were talking about state machines, and like, you and I like, both had essentially an implementation of state machines that we wanted to use. And you were like, we can use yours. And I was like, no, we can use yours. And like, it was literally us. And then at the very end, you're like, okay, well, we're both too polite to say which one to use. So like, you know, it doesn't really matter. And yeah, I don't know if you remember that specific interaction. But yeah, the TLDR is like, you were here at the very start. And anyways, like, it doesn't really matter. Like... how much or how little you contributed. Contribution is a contribution. It's important. Like, every bit matters. If I'm sure for real bugs, they're cuter than programming bugs. True. Are you guys afraid of bugs? I'm not, like, particularly afraid of bugs. I feel extremely grossed out by, certain bugs. So, like, I really don't like flies. Like, and gnats. They fucking disgust me. Like, I'm not scared of them. They're just disgusting. I hate them. But most other bugs don't really bother me. Oh, and centipedes. I really don't like centipedes. All the legs, they creep me out. It's gross. I remember now. I'm glad it's not just me, because this is an interaction that was over a year ago, if you think about it. I think the leaves are still a little bit too like far out. I need to pull it in a little bit more. Far out. Oh, has anyone seen the Barbie movie yet? I've heard good things. I really want to go see it. I really want to see Oppenheimer too. I asked some of my friends if they also forgive me if I'm pronouncing it wrong. Oppenheimer, I don't know, I'm sorry. Yeah, but I was like, I wanted to go see it with some friends, and they were like, let's make it a double, or you're talking about, like, possibly making it a double feature, like, seeing both, right? Like, it's the meme, but also I'm just like, dude, my brain's gonna melt from that much TV. I'm not sure about you guys, but, like, I just can't sit through that. Like, I will lose my concentration, and then I will just, like, my brain will truly explode. I hate bugs, particularly June bugs. Really? Today I learned about you. It takes super gnarly bug to get me grossed out. It's more if they touch me, though. I like seeing them. I don't like seeing them at all. I don't like them touching me. I got a cool centipede. No, 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 please don't. Like, please, please do not. I will be blocking you if you do. Like, please don't. It's... I actually had a really funny interaction with some family members a couple weeks... or recently. So, I was in Singapore, right? And we went to a bird park. Me and one of my, cousins, and the other cousin, she couldn't join us because she had to go to work that day, but also she hates birds. Like, she's not scared of them, she hates them. She finds them really gross. Like, kind of like, she feels about birds the same way that I feel about bugs. Or certain bugs. And so then my other cousin kept sending her the pictures at the bird park of birds, and she kept sending us, like, dot 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 back. And I was like, you, and the, like, these two cousins in particular, they're sisters, right? I'm like, you already know she doesn't like birds. Why are you sending her these pictures? And she was like, you know, to help her overcome her hatred. And I was like, it's kind of awful of you. Oh, siblings, am I right? Oh, wait, stop, 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 stop! No, don't open! Oh, god. Okay, I thought it was... Because, right, I said I had, like, a tutorial for it. And I thought I was about to blast the audio, like, on full blast. And I was like, no, please, don't do that. Barbenheimer. Yeah, I've been seeing the memes. It's so good. Don't start remembering that stuff. I get nervous about it all the time. Worried, obviously, as a creep. I have, like, it... Like... I'm honestly quite frightened sometimes by my memory, because my memory truly is, like, excellent. Just, like, speaking a little more... Sorry, that sounds narcissistic, but I really do have a really good memory. That's the wrong button. Especially for things in particular that I hear. I'm a very, like, hearing-based person. What the fuck is going on here? I'm so confused. I did something went a little bit wrong, I think, with the extrude. Wait, do I have overlapping anything here? No. Huh. Oh wait, that makes sense. I'm actually a clown, okay. Psychological weapons. So interesting to hate birds like that. I should bird watch so I actually know what they're called. It's annoying with the things I tend to remember. I'm just inconsistent. I mean, I feel like, right, there is a word for it, but like the type of memory, right? Because I also say, like, specifically, right, like, my memory is, one, really good with things I hear, and two, more specifically, my memory is really good with things about, kind of more, like, not about people, but kind of tend to have to do a little bit more with something related to a person, right? So, like, oh, shit, there's an extra phase here, I did it wrong. I was supposed to do a cut here and then do this. Yep. But yeah, I'll like remember something about a person. Like I'll remember your birthday. Really, I'll remember your birthday or whatever. But there's a lot of things I also can't remember. Right? Like not so great with like the textbook memorization, for example. Because, like, I don't really care about those things, right? It's like, I don't have stakes in it. I think I have a good memory for things that I, like, quote-quote have stakes in. You know what? I'm really not too happy with how the shape is coming along. I'm gonna flatten. Whoa! Why'd I do that? Flatten the whole thing and just like I can't memorize trivia and straight data. Or remembering her. You're better at remembering gossip and useful info, if I get it. Or. Info, I get it. Indeed. Why is her hair so big? It's full of secrets. I'm remembering horrible things that I have been said. Like, wait, things that have been said to you or things that you've said to other people? I remember a compliment I got 5 years ago. That's good. Remember the good things. I also remember, you know, nice things that people have said to me. Stranger said he liked my jacket. Oh, hell yeah! Fashion compliments are the best. I do really like it when people compliment, like, my clothes. Or, like, not my clothes specifically, but, like, you know, my fit. Because I'm like, hell yeah, I got dressed by myself today. Let's fucking go, baby. Also, just realized, wow, hold up. This leaf is so thin. Not vibing with it. Oops. Mr. Question is here. Hello, Snow. How you doing today? What's up, my friend? By the way, I've been meaning to tell you this for like a month now, and I keep forgetting because I've been so busy. I've watched Ruby Volume, whatever the newest one is. I'm perplexed in a lot of ways. I remember nice things to you, not just those effective. I meant things said to me, but I guess both. I love complimenting people's fits. It's fun making people feel good about themselves. Hell yeah. Especially since, like, I mean, everyone is different, right? But me personally, I do tend to, like, I think that I'm a pretty, like, fashionable person. And not just that I'm fashionable, but it's also kind of, like, I put effort into, like, just wearing something nice every day. Because, you know, like, I joke about it sometimes with some friends, but also, like, I'm just like, I can't control what happens in a day. You know, and I can't, there's a lot of things I can't change in a day, but at least I can change what I wear, and if what I wear impacts how I feel, then why not? You know, if I feel like I'm wearing just, like, a shirt, a t-shirt, and, like, shorts, I will feel as if, like, I don't know, I'm being lazy around the house, so that's how I feel when I'm outside. If I put on, like, a blazer, I'll be like, I feel powerful. No spoilers, I'm slacking in anime right now. I had to make a stupid fucking Crunchyroll account, right? And then I had to give them my credit card, then I had to cancel it once I finished volume 10. Or whatever, is it volume 10? I don't even know. But... no spoilers? For sure. But... I did like this volume a lot. Honestly think... I liked it a little bit more than some of the previous volumes. But I won't, like, talk too much about it. You get it. You look good, feel good. Exactly. I can't do fashion in California. It's too hot. I mean, I will wear a full, like, blazer. I'll wear a full-ass blazer even when it's, like, hot as balls out. You can't stop me. Me being like, I don't need to subdivide twice, it's too high poly that way, but then remembering... Did I get it? No, I didn't. Oh, I did! Oh, wow! I didn't just kill it, I decimated it! Oh my god! Oh my god, it splattered all over my palm! Oh my gosh, I'm sorry. I feel kind of bad now. It's not like I didn't kill it in one chunk. Like part of its wing is on. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Like I dismembered it. Its body is all split up. But anyways, what was I saying? Yeah, I will wear a full ass fucking blazer when it's hot as balls out for the look. Because again, you know, like, I can't control the way I look, but I can control what I wear, you know? And take control of what you can in your life, right? There's no use whining about things that can't be changed. I can feel upset about it, but there's no use whining about it. I saw the anime and decided to try out the OG show, I think Volume 2. Oh, I do, like, I think Ruby Volumes 1 through 3 / 4 are, like, phenomenal. I think they're very good. I can tell when someone's putting effort and they should get recognized. Hell yeah. That's very kind of you. Sorry, I just, like, had the heaviest... I don't know if you guys heard, but I just went, like, out of my mouth. I'm just like, why do I sound like a fucking heavy-ass, like, mouth breather? Or, like, why am I breathing so heavily anyways? Like, what's going on with me? Poor bug. Absolutely demolished. Holy shit, my dad just sent us 77 photos. Warning, after the beginning of 4, story goes down. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, there's like a bit of a reason for that, right? Like, because, Monty died, unfortunately. Kind of understand another thing that's bothering me about this shape. Sorry guys, I know I'm like I'm not a perfectionist. It's like me caring, as always, me caring about shit that literally nobody else cares about. That's me, classic me. You know what I've also been, like, so right, on the topic of Ruby, for example, like, I first started, I think, watching that in, wait, when did Ruby come out? Like, the original, it came out in 2013. I believe I started watching it in 2000, when did Ruby Volume 1 come out? Okay, so that one is 2013, and I remember watching the I do remember waiting for Volume 3 to come out. I didn't watch it in 2013, but I guess I watched it for somewhere between 2013 and 15. And something I have been thinking about recently, though, like, it's wild that, like, oh my god, wait, I've actually have been following this storyline for, like, close to a decade now, right? And, like, I was thinking about, like, specifically in the context of Genshin, too, I'm like, I've been playing this shit for almost 3 years now. But... I gotta go, actually. It was fun chatting, guys. Bye, Rogue! I'll catch you later. Thank you for stopping by. Good luck with your shoot. 8 and 9 pick up the slack. I did like Volume 9. Volume 9 was pretty good. I didn't really... I'm trying to remember which volume was which specifically. I did not really like the volumes, essentially, where, like, Ruby was... Wait, this is spoilers, actually. I'm not gonna say this, because... spoilers for Kevin. That's how I feel about Overwatch. Goddamn, right? Like, there's just some things that's like, I've been watching or playing this shit for too long, but you can't stop. It's getting hard to fight the urge. I'm getting tired of my wardrobe, just saving money in closet space. Clothes is indeed really expensive, especially in the States. Like, clothes is so expensive here. And, like, for no reason at all. I think I... Honestly, I think I just... I think my slight dissatisfaction with the shape, right, is like I just want all the leaves to be a little fatter. I think that really is it. Care, I'm not a huge fan. Oh, okay. Alright. I will say, I didn't like the volumes that Ruby was, adventuring with, like, the other dudes all that much. Not because, like, not even because I missed, like, original Team Ruby. It's more specifically that I really was dissatisfied with the number of subplots they opened. There were so many fucking subplots in those volumes. Like, is it just me? Like, one moment I'm supposed to care about, like, Ren and Nora's story, and then I'm supposed to care about, like, Weiss's mom, and then her little brother, and then the butler, and I'm like, there's too many characters going on here. And, like, I'm fine with having a lot of plots, but it's because, like, it was in those, like, the only character that I felt, like, actually had any, like... not like actually had any amount of growth, but the character who I felt like, because like there were so many other characters going on, it maybe drew attention away from being able to give like Team Ruby a stronger story. Like the only character that I kind of enjoyed seeing like their progression was Yang, and I think like right because she lost a fucking arm. I did not see the kind of growth that I would have wanted to see in, like, Weiss. Not Weiss grew, but the thing is, like, her growth was something that had already started a lot earlier, so it was, like, a little... Like, I don't know how to describe it. And some they didn't finish. No, exactly, like, the deal with her mom, like, that her, like, Weiss is... The character of her mom, like, makes, like, upsets me more than anything. Like, they really out here being like, yeah, no, so, like, Weiss is... Dad married her for, like, money. Like, okay, cool. Very common trope. And, like, the thing is, like, at the end, like, Weiss's mom helped, right? Like, I don't exactly remember what, but it was, like, it was a very common, like, writing trope of, like, oh, negligent mother, like, does something responsible and cares for child. But I didn't understand why, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't see enough development within the mom for me to understand and like feel like her doing the right thing essentially or like actually had any impact. It's like essentially like you didn't explain to me why this character had a sudden change in order to actually do that. Like you didn't show me, you didn't explain to me. Like her brother, I could understand a little bit more. Cause like I think like for me I could see that her brother was like understanding that like Oh, all of these things that I thought were important problems are actually really petty, and I am a small speck in the grand problem. So I'm gonna put my ego aside. Like, that I kind of understood a little bit more, but I really could not understand her mom, I think. Don't mind me, I just realized I forgot to actually, like, hit send on an important link. I have to post these builds that finally finished building. Yeah, I think the main reason those volumes are bad is because of the change in employees. Yeah. It is, like, really heartbreaking that, Monty, like, passed away, and it's such a... I don't know if I'm, like, this is gonna sound really cursed to say, but, like, when I first heard about that, I was worried that it was, like, another, like, it was, like, a he took his own life thing, but, it was an allergic reaction. I wonder if they're gonna even get greenlit for the next volume, honestly, because of the pandemic, I think, like, Ruby has definitely lost a lot of traction, and not just even, like, wait, hold on, there's something wrong with this edge, I wanna fix it, it's lost a lot of, I think, it's definitely lost quite a lot of viewership as kind of, like, expected out of the pandemic. And, like, in general, people, right, have been increasingly dissatisfied with it because, like, because Monty's not around anymore. I think what needs to happen here, actually, is this vertex needs to merge with this one. That's why everything's going kind of bonkers, I think. I'm not 100% certain, I'm not gonna lie. Red versus Blue by the same company. I've not watched it myself, but I do know what it is. It's a good one, yeah. But as if there's a huge void in the fight animation, but fun fact, he helped a lot with the story, if I remember correctly. Yeah. I mean, he's, like, credited as the creator entirely. Um, I kind of liked the fight choreo a lot more in this volume again, which is cool. Do this. Oh wait, that's not gonna why, man. There's a very simple like explanation for why it looks so bad and like or simple fix, sorry. And I'm just too dumb, honestly. Way. Also, like, on the topic, right, of, like, getting the next volume greenlit, I'm a little confused because, right, I mentioned that I had to, like, make a fucking Crunchyroll account and shit. And so, right, it must mean that Rooster Teeth made some kind of deal with Crunchyroll. Probably because they're looking for the extra funding, both for Ruby, but also the company. Because Rooster Teeth is, like, a pretty small, it's like a small company, you know? It's not a big behemoth corporation. It's like still, it's not an indie company, but it's not big. So they're gonna run into financial issues. Looking up arugula to make sure I know what arugula is. Yeah, arugula can look like that. I think it's because they made an actual anime, I think. Wait, what do you- sorry, I know we're talking about Ruby still, but what do you mean? Like, what do you mean by that? Like, they made a deal with Crunchyroll because they made an actual anime? Is that what you're saying? I just want to understand. What just happened? Why? What the fuck? How about we just delete the history on that? Okay, yeah. There's a history issue. With Studio Shaft. Wait, so, again, I'm still kind of confused by, like, why that's important. Like, are you saying they sold the rights to Ruby, essentially, or...? I mean, the fact, I mean, either way, if they made a deal like that, it must have been for money. Financial. My Monstera, really, do you be looking like a Monstera? Wait, what's going on with this edge? Why is it... Oh, because it's going through the image plane. It's like, what happened to it? Why did it get cut off? Well, they licensed it to Crunchyroll. Oh. I mean, right, but like, what I'm saying is like, the reason they would have probably done that as well is like to get money to so they can greenlight the next volume. Because I don't know if Rooster Teeth had many layoffs, but I can't imagine that it didn't, right? Which, I used to watch a lot of their podcasts too. I really enjoyed Always Open for a while. Just because of like, right, candidness. It's called Always Open and they were very honest about a lot of things. I really like I don't know about anymore because I haven't watched it in a while, but I really, really liked Barbara Dunkelman. Like, I think she's cool. I liked it, but I watched it before the original. I mean, I have my understanding as well of like people who have watched the anime as well as like right the original Ruby. I know people like it. I know people are Ooh, I duplicated it by accident. Hello? Go to this point, thank you. Ow, my cheek. But yeah, I know people like kind of like the animation. They think it's kind of cute. Or at least like some people like it. I don't know. I haven't seen many haters for it though in particular. Then again, I don't really frequent Reddit all that much. Here, let me look up some screenshots from the anime real quick. Okay, so they have the same outfits too. Oh, I will say, despite not liking the volumes all that much, I really did like this era of their outfits. I thought it was a fucking banger, man. Like Ruby looks so good. I think Blake looks amazing. Yang looks amazing. Why is his eye? I don't like these new outfits. These are atrocious, I think. Like, Weiss looks awful. Or, like, what is it? Volume 9 or whatever? I don't know. Volume 9. Yeah. Outfits. Like, let me just get a good... Like, these outfits... Oh, wait. This is a fan edit. These are atrocious. I actually think they're so fucking hideous. Like, well, like, Ruby's is okay. Yang's is okay. But what the fuck are Blake and Weiss wearing? It's so ugly, in my opinion. It's awful. Like, her, like, the sleeves look terrible. I'm like, I am not a fan of this weird zipper texture on Blake's. Oh, this is a fan concept art. Like, even I even like their original outfits more. Like, they were plain, but they were cute. Like, this is nice. I think it suits, it's like, it suits her. Oh yeah, these outfits were nice too. Why didn't they bring these back? Anyways, moving on. I just hate some of the animations, but the story from what I watched is good. I mean, it is purely Ruby, right? It's like a copy-paste, essentially, of the story. Am I not mistaken? I'm not gonna lie, I still don't actually know the different curve types, so I think... Because I think I wanted this. Yeah. Sorry, I don't know what came over me. I just really had to sound like a frog with a frog in its throat. That sounds that's a bad that makes no sense. It had a new story. Oh, it did have a new story. Interesting. Okay, maybe I'll have to watch it now. I will, like, I am thinking about it a little bit, right? Like, why did I like this particular volume of Ruby a little bit more than the previous ones? And, like, honestly for me, I gotta say, it had my attention. I think that's the thing about a lot of the previous volumes, it just simply did not have my attention. You know, like, for one reason or another. Starts off the same as volume 1, then introduces a new arc. Oh, interesting, okay. Maybe I'll give it a watch, who knows. But again, you guys all know me, I'm not a big TV watcher. Like, any- getting me to watch TV or like, is kind of a feat in and of itself. Okay, we do not need that many tens, probably enough. Okay, it's a little chunky, still 12. 15. 14. I can live. Recently watched Peacemaker. Not much else, though. I really enjoyed that. Never heard of it. I'm assuming... I feel like, I mean, is the title indicative of what it's about? about the supervillain and hero peacemaker and his attempt at being a better person. DC Comics, and it's quite the comedy. Oh! Wait, it's an anime? Oh, we're just talking about TV. Ah, I know this one now. It's John Cena. Okay, I know what you're talking about now. I thought it was an anime. I do know what you're talking about. I did see trailers for it. It does look fun, and I like John Cena. He seems like a chill dude. I feel like, honestly, my criteria for, like, being like, I like insert celebrity name here, is like, they're a chill dude. Because, like, listen, I do indeed very much like it when people are chill and normal. Obviously, I don't know John Cena, so I can't speak to if he's chill or normal. However, if he's a famous person and at least, like, looks, like, is, like, from an appearance perspective, right? Just, like, from what you see of them on social media, and if they look like a chill enough person just from that, I'm just like, good enough for me, honestly. Good enough for me. Because I'm never gonna know you. So, like, I don't need to know if you're actually chill or not, but you seem chill, and that's enough. It's the only good thing DC Comics has done. Excuse me! I liked Wonder Woman a lot. The first one. The second one was kind of meh. I didn't really understand the story. John Cena has done the most Make-A-Wish appearances of any celeb. I did see that stat. I feel like Paul Rudd has also done a lot. That's another, like, I feel Hollywood perplexes me a lot, being like, I like this movie star or whatever, because I'm like, I've never met them, and I likely will never meet them, and even if I do meet them, I'm never gonna know them enough to, like, judge them on the basis of, like, I like this person, right? But, sorry, looking up a quick reference. Okay. They usually do get very big and very tall. Ooh, they have holes in them. I don't want to put a hole in mine. Okay, the Monsters in Animal Crossing don't have holes. I'm not putting holes in mine. anyways. Again, yeah, I do feel it's really strange to be like, I like an XYZ, like, movie star. Because I'm, again, I don't know this person, I'm never gonna know them, truly. But I gotta say, I like Paul Rudd. He also seems like a chill, nice dude. He seems laid back. People get too attached. It's weird, yeah, parasocial relationships are freaky, man. And right, like, something I was thinking about, like, because not too long, like, with, like, a couple months ago, right, I was driving through Hollywood. I don't remember why. I think I was trying to go somewhere. I think I was going to the observatory or something, like, Griffith Observatory with some friends. And, like, going through Hollywood, I just, like, felt, like, weird, you know, because we did drive by some movie studios, and I'm just like, there's people out there waiting to see if they spot a movie star or whatever, and I'm like, okay, you guys are literally stalking these people. Like, they're not, like, yes, actors are very talented, like, and that's cool and all, but everyone is talented at something, and, like, these are normal people, like, trying to live their lives. Why are you, like, waiting to get a sight and, like, take a creepy-ass photo of them and sell it? Like, it's psychotic. It's so wrong. Like, it's disgusting. Again, these are just people! They're just trying to live their lives, man! LA is all about that clout, I know, and it just, it freaks me out, man. Thank you. BRB, alright, all good, be safe. Hydrate, posture check. Oh. Oh, my back just cracked. Crazy over social media followers and crap. I've had multiple people freak out a bit because I was talking to them and I had 10k YouTube subs, and it's like, yeah, like, because I can, again, I can understand, like, where, like, the obsession, quote-quote, like, if that's the right word, comes from, because, right, like, you know, like, in, when you were doing YouTube, right, you had a lot of people, commenting on your, like, videos and stuff, and there is a lot of people to talk to, so it can become really overwhelming, and it becomes easy to not talk to everyone. And then so when someone does get, like, selected, I guess, or, like, I don't know, they said something that caught your attention that, like, made you, like, want to reply to it either way, it is, like, it is a feeling of, like, oh my gosh, but also at the same time, like, it's true of everyone. Like, sorry, I don't mean it like that, but, like, arguably, like, I don't know, never mind. I take back kind of what I meant, said about, like, it's true of everyone, but again, like, I understand, like, from the sheer volume perspective, right, they're getting a little overwhelmed, or, like, people on social media and who have a lot of followers get overwhelmed with the volume of people commenting on their videos and stuff, and so they can't reply to everything. So it's kind of cool when you do get a response, but again, people are just people. And, like, I didn't respond to you because you're special, and I didn't not respond to you because I don't, like you. I just, you know, you respond to things that you feel like you have something to say, and that's, like, that's what I kind of meant by, like, it's true of everyone. Like, if you feel like as if you don't have something to say, then why would you respond to any particular comment or something someone said? So I'm getting kind of hungry. I had lunch at, like, 4, though. Why am I hungry? Oh, I guess it is almost 8. But still, that was only, like, 4 hours ago. Goddamn. I think some of these people are quite young, too. Yeah. I think, like parasocial also is, like, very much, like, right when you develop a parasocial relationship, it is gonna come a lot, results a lot from someone's age, too. Because I think the older you get, not to say that, like, like, the older you get, the more, right, you kind of have these realizations that it's like, oh, these are indeed just people, and, like, you run out of time, quote, not run out of time, but, like, quote-quote, worship manifests and comes across a little differently, I'd say. Because I think for me as well, like, for example, like, I keep saying for example, I'm sorry. I really used to gush a lot over, Let me try and think. Who was a movie star or TV star, any kind of famous person that I really liked and like had that reaction where it's like I see them on TV or something or see them in a movie, I'm like, oh my god, I love them. Oh my god, I'm just trying to think of the movies I liked as a kid, too. Was I a personality-less blob as a child? I did watch a lot of TV when I was younger. Not like a lot, but I watched movies! I'm blanking on every film I've ever enjoyed. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm actually drawing a blank so hard right now. But also, when I mean, I liked animation more growing up too, so I'm having a hard time like coming up with like quote-unquote a giga star, right, that would be like physically recognized on the street, because like animation is like harder to like they're people that are able to like most of the time lead slightly more normal lives because it's an animation. You don't see who it's like you don't see the person behind the voice. Okay, I have one, finally. I really, really liked Orlando Bloom, because I really liked Lord of the Rings, right, when I was like 10. I still like it, but I really liked Orlando Bloom. There, finally thought of one. And like, right, when I was younger. But like, the thing is also these days, I feel like I consume so much less media that it's a hard time, I have a hard time also even being like, who am I gonna fangirl over, right? Like, all these new people who are famous, I don't know who they are, I really don't. Like, all these names that I hear, it kind of tosses around, like, really frequently, like, Olivia Rodrigo. I don't even know if they're a movie star or a musician. Like, I know the name, but I don't know who they are, and I don't know what they do. Because I have never really, like, had time or energy or even, like, desire to go see the things that they might be in. Stuff like that. And same with, like, kind of, like, right, when I was younger, Bridge, okay. I definitely watched, like, a lot of, like, Markiplier, and it's, like, same, like, with these, like, other famous people, or, like, YouTube famous people, too, as well. Like, I don't know, like, any YouTubers these days, so, like, I don't have any inclination to, like, quote-unquote gush over any of them, because I don't know who they are. Like, does Markiplier still even make YouTube videos? I think he does, right? Wasn't there that thing recently where he, like, fucking broke the internet with his OnlyFans? I feel like I read about this recently. I didn't mean into it either. I've been quite nervous around people I think are impressed. I mean, it's a natural thing. You're talking about social media? We're talking about, like, fan worship, kind of, like, where, like, parasocial relationships where, like, you meet someone that's, like, famous or whatever, and you just, like, or, like, obsession over famous people. Okay, sorry, I got distracted because someone was asking me an important question about the build, XD. But yeah, I feel like... Snow, what are your thoughts? I feel like... I kind of feel... get the impression that you will have a lot of similar thoughts as, like, kind of what Kevin and I have been sharing. Where the fuck is the tool? Ugh, oh, I've been running into this... Oh, it's there, okay. There we go. I don't know, I have been running into this bug recently with Maya where, like, the gizmo doesn't, or, like, the little thing doesn't show up for some reason. And then sometimes you just have to restart, or sometimes you just have to, like, button mash around for a little bit and it'll show up eventually, but I don't know what the issue is. I mean, it's not that big of a deal, I don't really care that much, but... It's a very tiny bug, like, I can live with it. I ain't gonna die. But yeah, the concept of like worship with like famous people, I just find it very strange. And like, I find paparazzi really sick. It's disgusting. Leave these people alone. They're people like us, like you. You know, they're really not that different. They have jobs. Their jobs just happen to put them on TV. They want to go and like they want to go home after work and spend time with their family or just chill. Like, you know, they want to live their own lives without being bombarded by cameras. Made a paragraph on accident. Not all good. I have no say there because I know no one. Literally, the closest thing I have to that is you, but even then, I don't. No offense. I watch you as background noise and deep in thought. Question one, consider that as thought. Yeah, I mean, like, I by no means am like, because I'm on Twitch, I'm famous. Like, no, I'm not. Like, I do not do any of this for any amount of, like, worship. I just want to chill and meet and like meet some nice people every now and again and have a good time. That's all I want. That's literally all I want. Honestly, we could put this in the flower shop too. Oh, by the way, I just want to share one quick thing about that actually, because I think I might have shared it a couple weeks ago. Never mind, I don't need to. Like, I did update the flower shop a little bit, like from a visual perspective, like shrinking it, making it a little smaller and tighter. Wait, monster. Here it is. Here's my tab. Monster plant. Okay, they do tend to have a lot of leaves. Like, it's pretty bushy, so I should probably make one more variant. Not bushy. Bushy's not the right word. It is pretty leafy. Kind of almost want to make one more variant that is like, why, what is this? Oh, I'm dumb. Whoa, want to duplicate the object, not extrude it. Honestly, more like this. Like, kind of more like the actual picture, because the picture, right, you see it's 1, 2, 3, I made it 4. I want to maybe have one that's a like chonky leaf, so we're gonna... Collect Collapse edges? No. I thought there was an option to essentially bring edges together, but I guess not. Okay. I really, here it comes again, me always being like, I hope I looped the playlist. I don't think I did, it's not playing. Oh, it is. It's just there's a little bit of an end, little sequence. I got a message a couple weeks ago about a game project I made like 2 years ago. Hell yeah, that's cool though. Glad to see it's still getting the appreciation. This might be a little bit more of a serious question, so you don't have to answer it if you don't want to. But like, how do you feel you've changed as a creative, Kevin, over the years? Do you feel like you've changed? Because for me to be never mind. I really did not like the way that I said that. Because for me, I'm just like, oh, it's all about me, obviously. Ugh. Sometimes I can't stand myself, man. Anyways, do you feel kind of, again, if it's getting too heavy and like personal, we can be like, let's not talk about this. Because again, it is a pretty highly personal question. But do you feel like happy, like kind of with where you're at right now, creatively? Am I crazy? Yes. Am I work? No. Like, I'm very happy with my growth as an artist, but I feel very restricted by money. How do you mean by restricted? Like, you feel like, is it kind of like you feel like you can't do what you want because of money, or you wish you were making more money off of what you're doing? I don't know. Maybe those are kind of the same question, but... I gotta go, guys. I wish you wealth and prosperity. Love you guys. Thanks, Snow. Thanks for stopping in. And I hope you have a lovely rest of your evening. Hope you bang chill or play some Vidja games. You know, have a good time. It's summer. Enjoy life a little. And I will catch you next time. There's a lot to it, I can imagine. Yeah, sorry, it's kind of a heavy question, I'm sorry. Sorry, give me one second, I just realized I need to text my parents about something. Give me a second. Alright, I'm back. I don't think it's heavy, just would take many paragraphs to explain. That also makes sense. I guess, like, maybe not emotionally heavy, but still a heavy topic that is gonna require some, you know, like you said, explanation. But yeah, we don't need to get into it. If you do ever want to talk to someone about it, though, I'm all ears, but it was just a kind of just something, like, I asked. Oh, that's not a bug, it's a fuzzball. I ask because it's, like, also kind of a question that I've been thinking about myself lately, about the, like, are you satisfied, with your work? Are you satisfied with, like, who you've become as an artist? Blah, yada, 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 yada. What happened to my second bin? Oh, because I hadn't selected the object, I think. It's even easier for you to talk here than me typing. It's true. It is very true. This is actually something that, like, Rogue brought up yesterday, too. He was like, the fact that we're having this conversation. It's like a very one-sided channel of communication. Yeah, it's, you know, another thing I've been thinking about, I guess, actually. Like, right, streaming, on one hand, like, I've always, something I've talked about before, like, I guess this actually goes back to kind of what we were talking about earlier with the celebrity worship and, you know, parasocial relationship. Because I will admit there has been more than one instance where, like, I kind of felt as if, like, people watching cross a little bit of a physical boundary, and I'm just like, remember, people, please, that I am a stranger on the internet. I don't know you, and you don't know me, so you can't talk to me this way. Like, I don't, you know, you can't talk to me like this, blah, blah, blah. You can't assume you know me. That's one thing, but also, again, a stream is a one-sided communication, right? I'm the only one who gets to talk. And it's very strange. I don't know. I think I've been thinking too much lately, honestly. My head, like, kind of hurt. Not completely one-sided, but I get you. You've been very introspective on stream lately. I've generally been an introspective person. Or not generally have been. I generally am an introspective person. I think a lot about, like, the things that happen around me and the things that I feel. I don't understand them most of the time, but I try to think about it. Also, like, because I've been thinking about my thesis a lot recently, too. Right, because I am getting into the second year of grad school and, like, thinking about why I came here. I don't mean as in, like, oh, why'd I come here? It's a waste. Like, very, very valuable experiences for me so far, but again, like, why did I come? Like, why did I want to do grad school? Who am I as a person? Who am I as a creative? What do I want to say? You know? And, like, how does my creative voice translate or relate? And how is it important to who I am as a person? You know? Oh dear God, my mom's calling me. Hold on, 1 second. Ah! Face went Literally, your mom, like, calls you for something that could have been an email. Or in this case, a text, but... That do be how my parents are. They're like phone calls. Wait, did I think I might delete the history already? Okay. That's fine, that's fine. I just want to basically reuse this curve.
Thank you.
Not exactly perfect, but it's like good enough to use some of these to represent like the small like budding leaves. Honestly, actually, let's just delete it. Don't need it. That look weird. I think it looks a little weird. Maybe I have to- wait, let me give everything colors first too. That might help. Okay, it definitely looks a little less weird, but I still think it's strange. Maybe it just needs more leaves in general. Yo, I was checking on my builds. And they finally uploaded after an hour. Thanks, Doodoo Wi-Fi. So I was uploading via my laptop, not my PC. Blech. I'm sorry, what? Where was that pivot from? It was a little bit of a... I don't know, maybe I think I hit some toggle. Monsteras do look kind of weird. They like flow outwards a little bit more than other plants, I think, like big leafy plants, but this still looks just weird. So they're not right. No one's ever gonna see the bottom. Well, they might, but at least not in this render, so not my problem right now. I just went to scratch it. They're so itchy recently because I got back right from Asia, and there's a lot of bugs in Asia, and they itchy. So yeah, no, this looks awful. We're getting rid of it. A lot of mosquitoes in Southeast Asia, and they bite, and it gets itchy, and it sucks. I've been aggressively applying, like, an ointment. like, I have this, like, little liquid bottle thingy, like, liquid. It's, like, basically, like, you rub it on top of bug bites and it makes it feel cool. Because, like, bug bites, you know, when they get itchy, they become all, like, red and swollen and they feel warm, so this specific thing is just, like, to cool it down. Or make it feel more cooled, so you don't scratch as much. Sleepy. I'm not gonna lie, the jet lag, or sorry, I don't mean as in I'm not gonna lie, but it is the jet lag, and honestly, I slept okay last night, although not the greatest, because at least for me, I don't know about you guys, but like, I have a couple of predictable patterns within jet lag, at least for myself, right? First night usually is fine after coming back that I sleep okay because I would have been so exhausted from sitting on the airplane that long anyways. And then second night tends to be a little doo-doo, but last night I think I got like 6 hours of sleep. It was pretty solid. Like, I slept from pretty much right when stream ended until like 2, and then I fell asleep again from 5 to 7-ish. Honestly, this is pretty damn good. Oh, sorry, kind of a yawn. I may end a little. I may end soon and just tuck in a little early, because again, that's my pattern when fighting jet lag, and then. Yeah, like, end up going to bed kind of early. Third day, because I'm a little pooped. Why did this not end up right? Oh, it's not centered with the... thought I had, but I guess not. Or maybe I'd drag it out again. Where's duplicate special? There it is. There we go. Very much. Don't like the shape. Which one's the original? This one? Yeah. I mean, in all fairness, it's not really as if it's visible anyways. See how it looks. Just combine it all into one for a moment. Mm-hmm. really hate the file navigation, like, UI in Maya. Huge. In all fairness, once there are pretty big looking plants too. Now, where should I put it? Also, what's a good angle for this looks better in the render? Well, that's nice. Oh, that's not nice. Because the big leaf looking too big is also bad. An isometric view constraint. Yeah, see, that looks awful. I think that looks good. Or we can stand to turn it a little more to get a little bit more shape in. Alright, yeah, where do we put it? Also, wait, let me change my camera. Over here. The monster right here. Yeah, now that plant looks kind of weird over there. Rotate this. Yeah, I don't know how much I like that. It looks kind of little too cramped. No. I meant the shelf itself. It's too tall looking. Not the umbrella layer. Because umbrella rack is definitely important. I can't tell if I'm... I can't even tell if I'm being sarcastic or not when I say that. I think that's cute. It's a very green cafe, which is nice. Green is good. Yeah, I'm gonna call it there because I have a couple of other things I need to get done as well before going to bed tonight. So anyway, I mean, we finished the Monstera. Like, it took a couple of years, but we finally made one. We finally made one that I'm happy with. I can't believe it. All it took was someone on YouTube showing some tips and tricks. I guess it's not even tips, but just, like, studying their approach. Like, they went with a much more start. Honestly, it's what I'm noticing all the time. It's like, always start more flat. You think you're flat enough? Start flatter. Always start flat. Don't start with the curvature. And I think that was my wrong approach. I always tried to start with the leaf shape a little bit too much. Now the two colors are a little bit too dissimilar. They need to be not that far off each other. Wrap up for today because I gotta do a couple more things before I can tuck into bed. But yeah, this is where we're at. Here's the actual render. Oh, the render's missing the milk, even. I should... I'll make another render, actually, at the end of stream. Whoa, wait, this is the... There we go, because these are the progressive renders. Oh yeah, the very, very first render of, like, what I was trying to do for Out of a Cafe. Yeah, we abandoned this completely. And now we got this. I mean, first render... I didn't... This one, I waited for longer than usual for the first render. I really don't know why. Didn't have alpha on. Anyways, yeah, I'm done for today, but... yeah, I'm done for today. Next stream, I'll be completely honest, I'm not too sure when it's gonna be able to be, because my parents are in town on the weekend, and then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, well, my parents are here with the weekend through, like, Wednesday-ish. So, honestly, no idea when the next stream will be, but I really want to, rescue the Deku Tree after yesterday. We almost had it. Just ran out of arrows, which was tragic, but yeah, we'll get them next time. But anyways, either way. Thank you, everyone, for coming by. Have a great rest of your evenings, and I will see you when I see you, I guess. Sag. Alright, bye now!